At Colbert Station in Limerick, Ray Leamey arrives to drive the 150 train to Limerick Junction, carrying connecting passengers for the Cork and Dublin intercity trains.
Well, basically, Marion, this is my office. This is where I work from. And I've been in the railway for 30 years, almost to the week. I came in 1989. And it's a fantastic job. I've enjoyed every single year of it. It's responsible, of course. Obviously, it is a responsible job. And you have great colleagues you can work away with. And I think you kind of get a buzz out of it more than anything.
Ray was born in England to Limerick parents and lived in Essex and London before returning home to Ireland when he was 11. And his passion for trains was already firmly embedded.
I suppose from a very early age, I was always, even where we lived in Braintree in Essex, you could see the train from the front window. So when I was a baby, I was looking out of the train. Then I used to travel over to my uncles and aunts in Whittam, which is only 8 or 9 miles up the track. Railways have always been there. I've always had the interest. It didn't just grow on me. I just always had that interest, that fascination.
You might think Ray would have enough of trains with his day job, but no. Most of his time off centres around his obsession with model railways.
Daddy, what's a train? Is it something I can ride? Does it carry lots of grown-up folks and little kids inside? Is it bigger than our house? Well, how can I explain when my little boy asked me, Daddy, what's a train?
Well, at the moment now, we're in my attic, and this would be my domain. As you can see, it's a huge model railway setup. I have cameras, there's trains that can be kept down at the back that you can't see. So you have the camera here, that you can see it there. You have the control panels all here. These are all for the station. At the moment, it's very busy up here. There's an awful lot of trains shooting from one side to the other. So I keep diaries, as you can see, of every single train that would actually move. You can go back into 1960s, any time you want. And as you can see, certain things that happened within my family, I have marked out. So it's like a diary as such.
Trains are not Ray's only preoccupation, however. He's multi-talented, with interests ranging from boats to motorbikes, and he's even taught classical guitar. But above all, Ray is a family man.
We used to go everywhere. We went to all different railway museums, and then when we were going to my uncle's house, we used to go to Braintree, which is in Essex, just outside London, and we'd sit and watch all the trains coming by. In the evening, there's photos of us all, myself and my brother and my cousins, and we're all just on the platform watching the trains coming past, because they used to go so fast in England compared to here. It was brilliant. We used to have a great time.
Nearly all our holidays involve some form of going to see trains, steam trains. And even if you're not going to see a preservation, we go to see stations and trains flying through places. Up to the National Railway Museum. The last holiday we went to was at the Central Railway Museum in Loughborough in June, which was fantastic. And I love it.
See you again, Martin. Take care. Nice meeting you. Take care.
I mightn't have the interest in as much as Ray, but I love the fact that we travel and you see all the different places.
Not content with being confined to the attic, Ray suggested to Wifey Dell that he had an idea to redesign their modest suburban garden.
I decided about 3 years back, I had seen these in England when we used to go over when the children were very young, and I was always fascinated by garden, right on garden railways. And I have a small garden, so I didn't think it was possible to build one of these. I contacted a company in Ashford in Kent called Maxi Tracks. They told me exactly what I needed to do. I gave them the dimensions of the garden, and they told me the sharpest curve that engine can take is 8 foot. And if you can fit that in your garden, you can fit a ride-on garden railway in it. The grandchildren absolutely love it. They really do. They could spend hours out here. So I really don't know. I always say I built it for the grandchildren, but I don't think so. I built it for myself. This is my workshop. I'm working on a project at the moment. This is a 16-ton mineral coal wagon that would have been very numerous in British Rail days. And as you can see, it's not completely finished at the moment. There's a little seat for Charlie, the grandson. He'll be sitting in this, and obviously there'll be a harness to keep him in there as well. And basically, I order the wheels because the wheels are made of steel and they have bearings in them to take the load and the weight. So I order the wheels bolt in underneath, and then the rest of it, then there's a little running board, as you've seen on the train outside in the garden, where you put your feet on, and it connects then. There's little buffers in this side, and there's a little drawbar that you get that'll go onto the wagon itself, and this is actually what pulls the wagons around.
What is it about model railways that so fascinates a real train driver?
Model railways give you that great perspective, because not only is it a model railway, you're actually creating a world in front of you. You know, a lot of it, when people look at it, they don't see the actual detail that went into it, the effort that went into it. You might see two little plastic people on a platform, but to me, they're my uncle or my brother or somebody having a conversation, waiting for a train to come, or just after getting off a train. So it's all these little things you associate with it.
He does all the work in the house. Anything that needs doing, he did the bay windows. Just because when you're building models, you can transfer the skills for doing that to other things. And that's what's happened. So he saved us a fortune.
Admittedly, there's a lot of the family now give out when I come up here at 11 or 12 o'clock at night with a glass of wine. They're not too enthusiastic about it. And I always tell them the 12:15 is on its way, and once that clears, we'll pack it up.